Hey, so I just finished watching Six Underground, and it was not great. So I hadn't really had a negative moe review before in a while. And I don't know if I would say this one's totally negative, because there's definitely potential here, and not everything here is bad. There are definitely parts about it that I liked. But eventually, it just came to the point where I was just waiting for it to be over. Like, that started to happen around the two-thirds in, I think. I was just like, okay, now I'm just waiting for it to be over, literally. Or maybe even just like an hour from the end, it got to that point. I was just like, okay, can this be over now? Which is a shame because it started out pretty good, and it started out with me thinking that I was actually gonna like it. But no, it actually turns out just being exactly what you think it's gonna be. It's pretty much exactly what you're gonna think it's gonna be. You know what to expect going in. The only thing that wasn't exactly what I thought going in was the writing was much weaker than I was anticipating. The writers had were the guys that did the Deadpool films, the Zombieland films, and Life, so I had expected a lot better than just occasionally good jokes and occasionally well-written dialogue, but it was definitely their weakest script. It's not even like a comedy, but like occasionally there's good lines of dialogue, but most of their dialogue is pretty bad and most of their story is pretty bad. It mostly feels like it's written by Michael Bay, which is not good if you know Michael Bay. The only Michael Bay movie that I've really liked was Pain and Gain, and that was because that one felt self-aware about how stupid it was. And that one just was a lot of fun throughout the whole thing. But this one just slowly loses. I lost interest in it over time as the movie went on, and it slowly became more of a drag as it went on. But like I said, as it started, it was pretty good. When it started, the first action sequence, I really enjoyed. There was this energy to it, there was pretty good humor. The gag with the eyeball was pretty funny. I liked Dave Franco in it too. The eyeball thing, going back to that, literally Tales from the Borderlands, by the way, which I love that game. Yeah, another thing that the movie did right was just having the action be really violent and just the movie being really violent overall. Another thing that's still from is the whole ending with the boat, which is basically just Die Hard with a Vengeance, when the top of the guy's head just explodes. That was fun. Yeah. The end credit scene, what was that trying to insinuate? That they were gonna do an Ocean's 11 thievery type deal, or what, or do like Casino, or what were they trying to imply with that? I don't know. But yeah, the action was pretty. Well, I mean, I'm not gonna say like it was great, but like it was pretty violent, so it was fun in that regard. But like it eventually lost its pep after you'd seen it so many times. The movie was definitely way too long. They should have shaved a lot out of it. For sure, yeah. I would say if the movie was way shorter, I would have enjoyed it way more. And who knows, I maybe even would have recommended it if it was shorter and they would have shaved out some of the things I didn't like. But as it stands, maybe I could recommend some of the action sequences or some of the quips that characters say or things like that. But I don't know. And there is potential, like I said there, because there is stuff there, and the visuals do look nice for the most part. And the acting's relatively fine for the most part. But it's just there's so many Michael Bay-isms, and which are usually negative, that overwhelm the film. That's usually not a good thing. So yeah, I'd probably give it like a 6.5 out of 10. Another film that I saw today was Darkman, which I'd like to briefly touch upon. That one I gave an 8 out of 10, and I loved Liam Neeson's performance in it. I just want to talk about it because I don't know if many people did. Liam Neeson was great in it. He bounced between really darkly funny to really emotionally resonant to kind of scary in a way. And all these just different emotional reactions, and he played them all off extremely well. And they all fit within Sam Raimi's campy tone. It felt a lot like the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man trilogy, which he also directed. There were some really cool cinematography shots, like the transition with Frances McDormand after the explosion. The story was fantastic. I love how subversive it was. I never quite got a handle on how it was going. I thought it did repeat the Tobey Maguire trilogy a little too much, and that was my big complaint from the movie. But other than that, I thought it was great. That's why I gave it an 8. yeah, I definitely recommend checking it out. It feels much different than any other comic book movie, even though we have an overabundance of those that we have now. It just felt kind of fresh after we've had, like, many of the newer ones. Maybe it's just because I hadn't seen the Tobey Maguire trilogy all that recently, but it just felt like, it felt like a weird mix of that Spider-Man trilogy, some of the more classic Batman films, and then some of the newer Batman films. It felt like a weird mixing pot of all that, but in a very good way. The movie did not outstay its welcome. It was only an hour and a half, and I think that was definitely a good thing. Who knows, I could have even used it being longer since I liked it so much. But yeah, I also thought the characterization was also fascinating. And it's interesting seeing the whole downward trajectory of the drama of it, too. And how more recent superhero films like Joker have also done the same thing. I also think that it also took, like, inspiration from, like, character studies, too. But yeah, so I just wanted to talk about that one briefly, too. All right, hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching. Bye!